My name is Paul O'Keefe. I am an assistant professor of psychology at Yale-NUS College, and I'm a social psychologist. So we're often told that we need to find our passion, but we often don't know what that means. It could mean a couple of things. One, it could mean that our interests are inherent and waiting to be revealed, and that we should follow those passions once they're revealed. It could also mean that you find your interests through a developmental process, through being engaged, through interaction with the domain, investing in the domain. So this is the crux of the distinction between fixed and growth mindsets of interest. So a fixed mindset of interest is the belief that interests are inherent, and a growth mindset refers to the belief that interests are developed. And these have some very real consequences. So one consequence is that if you believe your interests are inherent, and you've already got interests, you've already developed some strong interests, you might actually be shut out. You might actually shut out other interests because you've already located, you've already found your interests. Therefore, that precludes the development of other interests. Whereas if you have a growth mindset and you believe interests are developed, the fact that you might have very strong interests to begin with would not preclude the development of new interests. So we find that a growth mindset is actually associated with a much broader array of interests, variety of interests. And a fixed theory is associated with a narrower scope. And it also relates, these theories also relate to our expectations for motivation. So if you believe that interests are inherent and that when they are revealed, when they're found, that they present themselves in a fully formed manner, that should make pursuing those interests quite easy, right? You have limitless motivation. But if you, from the perspective of someone with a growth theory, you develop these interests over time. And because it's a developmental process, you actually encounter setbacks once in a while. So they expect that this will happen, they expect that difficulties will occur. So we find actually that people indeed believe these two things. Fixed theorists are more likely to believe that they will have limitless motivation once they find their passion, and that growth theorists think that once they find their passion, they will encounter difficulties at times. And when we actually examine this, when we spark interest in our participants and then get them to work on something that is quite challenging on that same topic, we find that when it's perceived as being difficult, growth theorists maintain that interest in that topic, whereas fixed theorists lose that interest. So this suggests that these interests, maintaining interest, can actually perhaps sustain motivation to pursue these topics in the future.